At this point in time, the CEOs of every major automobile company around the world have come to the view that electrification is in the future for all of us.
Many people's view around the carbon emissions and climate change would suggest that we have to, and I think many consumers want to too.
All investors, they're all following the same religion, which is a true belief in EVs and a true belief that EVs will replace ICE cars faster than people understand.
We see enormous interest on this from the Chinese manufacturers, which could be very significant, but it's fair to say all the automotive manufacturers are interested, and it remains to be seen who is the winners out of it.
I think more importantly, the partnerships that Better Place has formed with the electricity companies, the OEMs, it's really the combination of the two that tell us that actually we're onto something.
One of the absolute beauties of Better Place is that it allows for the build out of infrastructure to make electric cars a success without significant, maybe any, government funding and without consumers making great sacrifice.
In places like Denmark, they've had a differential put in place on the taxes provided to recognize the incremental cost that a combustion engine puts as a burden on the society and on the roads relative to an electric vehicle.
Each government, each politician would love to have lower cost transportation, reducing the oil import quandary, and of course helping the environment. This is a no-brainer for any politician.
It has elements of an infrastructure play. Once built out, it will have recurring revenues, it will have defensible features, it will have hard assets. But as a business proposition, it is so much more than that.
We are a conservative bank, and we're very careful with our capital. We really believe that this is the way forward in terms of pulling together what many of the governments, the OEMs, are focused on, which is electric vehicles playing a role in alternative transportation.
At VantagePoint, our mantra has been to work with the pioneering entrepreneurs on building the transformative companies of the 21st century. And we couldn't find a better template than Better Place.
If you look at Better Place, we don't see that as requiring a technological leap. It's a business model leap.
Every industrial business that I have, we're examining very carefully the carbon footprint and other environmental issues. And no question in my mind, it's beneficial to for the business itself.
Better Place is a very unique model. We haven't come across anything like it. And it has the potential to dramatically transform the electrification of transportation.
Where we think it's not so early stage is that the technology is well built out, and commercially it's well built out, and its period to potentially having very material revenues and profitability is quite short.
And we're very excited about the team that Better Place has put together and believe that they have a significant advantage over anybody that we've come across in this sector.
And our expectation is, quite frankly, that within 2 years, Israel and Denmark, as the first two launch markets for Better Place, will demonstrate that the business model works, both technically and commercially. We expect governments to visit that, to see that, and frankly, we think there'll be a race to copy it.
Better Place is, in a word, transformative.